Hello, my name is Leopoldo Armesto, and in this video we're going to talk about how to develop Bluetooth apps using App Inventor and also Facilino. So this is the outline of the presentation. First, I'm going to introduce the aim of our video and introduce the App Inventor that we have developed within the EcoThings project. And also we are going to talk about communication component properties, and also, we're going to explain how to read data from signals and sensors and how to set values to signals and actuators. And at the end of the presentation, I'm going to introduce the Facilino blocks that we use in order to, let's say, collect all the information from the app and return back the required responses. So our aim in this case is to develop an app that we want to communicate with an external device, in this case using classic Bluetooth, such as in this case an ESP32. But also we need to develop the code on the ESP32 side in order to handle the correct communication requests that are being sent by the app in this case. And of course we need to provide responses. And for that we use what we call a telegram. It's basically data with a specific structure that will be sent from the app to the electronics, and then the electronics will respond back to the app, and all this data will be processed and decoded. We will see how. So we mentioned that App Inventor allows the use of extensions, and we have developed an extension in order to work with a Bluetooth, in this case classic Bluetooth. And it basically it generates a Bluetooth client that manages all the communications with the external device. And together with this Bluetooth client, we have developed different kind of non-visible components that have been grouped into signal components, sensors and actuator components, and variable components. In the signal components, we can use it for, in this case, to read or write from digital or analog signals, like these components that you can see here, the analog read, analog write, or in this case, digital read, digital write. Okay, then we have sensor actuator components that can be used in order to read data from sensors or to send data to actuators, like could be, in this case, a buzzer like these ones, or could be a humidity sensor, or could be, in this case, a servo, a component in which can send an angle, things like that. And also we have variable components in which we can use it to store different kind of variables, and they are indexed, and we can use that for any purpose in our Arduino code. Okay, the extension can be downloaded in the URL that you can see here. So every component or communication component has basically the same properties. One of them is the Facilino Bluetooth client. So every application needs one Facilino Bluetooth client, and then we can add as many components in order to interact with signals and actuators and sensors as we want. And all these components will need to point to the correct Facilino Bluetooth client, which will be this component here. And in general, all the components have a pin. That means that this is the signal pin, or the where the servo is connected, or where the temperature sensor is connected. This is an information that the electronics need in order to provide the correct measurements or readings. And in case of variables, instead of a pin, we use an index. So as I said before, variables are indexed, so we can access to variable number 0, number 2, number 5, depending on what we want. And particularly sensors and variables that can read something, so request something to read and require a response, they have an update timeout setting here. So here you can find, we can see an example on how to read from signals. In this case, we are reading from an analog signal. In this case, is a potentiometer. It's using an analog read Bluetooth component. Also, we have a digital read signal, which is this component here. Also that one, but it's not shown because it's just basically a copy of that one. And here we have a clock that on request, or I mean, sorry, once the timer is triggered, we request to these signals, we request the value for these signals. And that sends a telegram to the electronics, and the electronics automatically, the user has nothing to sends back the value for the signals. In this case, will be once the value is received, will be notified. The user of the app will be notified here in this piece of code, or in this case, for the digital read in this piece of code. And a similar procedure, it's followed when we want to read from sensors. In this case, imagine that we implement a temperature Bluetooth sensor in which we request the temperature, and that is sent to the electronics. In this case, the electronic needs to implement a very small piece of code in order to actually read from the sensor and send back the temperature. And when it's received on the app, it will be notified here, and we can do, like in this case, to display the temperature on a label. And some sensors, they include additional, let's say, events that are specific, of course, on the sensor type, like in this case, a temperature, like if the temperature is higher than a threshold or lower than a threshold, we can be, let's say, warned here on specific events for this purpose. And also we have, as I mentioned before, actuators or signals that we can write on them. The way to proceed is very similar in all of them. We have methods in this case, like a set method for signals or the move method for a servo, in which we can send something to the electronic, in this case, a data or a value that it's sent to the electronic. And then with this data, the electronic needs to set the proper signal or needs to put the proper value or angle for a servo in this case. And here is actually the code that we need to implement in Facilino in order to actually manage all these communications. So this is an example of code, a very example of code in which we have defined it. Let's say our device, so it will be recognized in this case using this name here. So when we search for it, we will be recognized as on the Bluetooth list of devices, will be recognized as a multi-sensor in this case. And in the loop of the Arduino, we basically need to decode the telegram. So here we use this Bluetooth receive telegram instruction, in which we have, as you can see here, we have checked these signals here. That means that we allow the electronics that automatically handles all the digital read telegrams, or digital write or analog read in this case, telegrams that are sent from the app to the electronics will be automatically sent or managed by the instruction. So the user has nothing else to do. And then within this statement here, then we can add as many sections as we want in order to decode different type of telegrams. In this case, we have decoded the servo telegram and the temperature sensor telegram. For instance, in the servo telegram, the data that we send from the app to the electronics, remember that was an angle, but also the component has a pin associated. So in the end, the telegram will include a pin number and an angle. And this is what we receive here as the data of the telegram. And then here with this instruction, we say, okay, we want to move this servo, which is attached to this pin number, to this position here. Or for instance, the temperature sensor here that receives, basically it's a read sensor. So that means that we request, please give me the temperature of this specific sensor, which is connected to this pin. And then the electronics will respond back with the measurement that we get from this instruction here. That's a temperature sensor in which we just simply need to specify which is the pin is connected to, and that will be the value of the temperature that will be part of the data that it's response in the it's part of the response of from the electronics. Okay, so in this presentation, I have explained how to develop Bluetooth apps with App Inventor and Facilino. Thank you very much.